rule one of the game is that remember you should ask questions that only Mr. Premji can answer. He should not have the opportunity to tell me ki tum jawab do. Okay, one. Two is this that I am going to, you know, sort of, you'll have to raise your hands and I'm going to take, let's say, whatever question, whatever I feel like. Kabhi saamne se, kabhi peeche se. Theek hai? Uske upar aap log mujhe dosh mat dijiyega. Don't blame me for that. I'm going to be quite arbitrary about it. Theek hai? That's second. Third is this, that, you know, please keep your questions brief. Brief matlab, apne sawalon ko sankshep mein poochiyega. Theek hai? Is this okay? Yes or no? Quite simple rules of the game, na? Okay, so fine, great. So we'll start. And let me start with a question to Mr. Premji. These lights, can you slightly turn them down? So what you do is, turn them down, put up the lights in the auditorium, because I want to see the people's faces. Right, that's better. Is it okay? You have no problem with the lighting, right? You can still record. Yes or no? Yeah, okay. So, I am going to take this opportunity and ask him this question. Can I do that? Can I start? Yes? No? Please. Okay. So, Mr. Premji, why is Wipro committed to the environment?
I think it's very fundamental that we have a responsibility to the environment, and it's very much part of our DNA. We've been doing it from day one. It's very simple.
So he's saying it's a part of our DNA. We've been doing it from the very beginning. It's very, very fundamental, right? And that's as simple as it is. Nothing really dramatic about it. But the simple things are the most important things, right? Which is what he's saying. So now I'm going to open it up and let me see hands. Let me see hands. Ek hi haath. I mean, just keep your hands up. Just keep your hands up. Just keep your hands up, please. Otherwise, I will not be able to see them. Okay, so what we're going to do is, I'm going to point out three students at a time. So I'm going to take that girl there, one, two and three. Okay, so hold on. One, two, three. Everybody can keep, you, the two of you keep sitting. Huh? The two, yeah. So once she finishes a question, jab uska question khatam ho jayega, jab Mr. Premji jawab de denge, uske baad number two, then number three. Is it okay? Clear? Okay. Sorry? Zarur, zarur. Aap Marathi mein poochiye, Hindi mein poochiye, Angrezi mein poochiye. Marathi mujhe aati nahi hai. उनको भी नहीं आती है आपको ट्रांसलेट करना पड़ेगा ठीक है ना लेकिन कोई भी भाषा में पूछ सकते हैं उसमें कोई चिंता की बात नहीं पूछो पूछो
विप्रो पुरस्कार
जोर से
माझे नाव अमृता मधुकर गावाने वामनराव पदे माध्यमिक विद्यालय उमरेट या शाळेतून आम्ही येत आलोय हा विप्रो कार्यक्रम पुरस्काराचं म्हणजे हे प्रयोग सुरू करण्याचा तुम्हाला प्रेरणा कुठून भेटली
ट्रान्सलेट करिएगा टेक द माइक ट्रान्सलेट
तो उनका कहना है कि ये आप
जोर से
हेलो
वी कांट हियर प्रॉपर्ली हां हेलो इज हैंडलिंग द माइक्स मिस्टर प्रेमजी एंड आई कांट हियर व्हाट्स गोइंग ऑन
हेलो उसका ये पूछ रही है वो कि आपने ये जो विप्रो अर्थियन जो इवेंट स्टार्ट किया है वो स्टार्ट करने के लिए आपको प्रेरणा कहां से मिली मतलब आपके दिमाग में कैसे जो आइडिया है कि वो आपने ये प्रोग्राम स्टार्ट किया
गुड
वेल वी स्टार्टेड इट फॉर 7 इयर्स बैक एंड वी थॉट इट वाज इंपॉर्टेंट टू रिकॉग्नाइज पीपल हु हैड रियली मेड अ कंट्रीब्यूशन टू सस्टेनेबिलिटी वी स्टार्टेड आई थिंक ओरिजिनली विद स्कूल्स एंड देन वी ग्रेजुएटेड अप टू कॉलेजेस एंड वी आल्सो spread ourselves on a national network. Originally, it was much more close towards South India. I think it has got a lot of response in terms of participation. And the fact that they're just winners is not it. It has a much more broad-based participation from a lot of schools, and more importantly from a lot of students who are really getting more alerted now to being cognizant of sustainability in the environment, which is such a serious problem.
So, like you said, हम लोग चाहते थे कि ये करें कि जिससे कि जो लोग सस्टेनेबिलिटी में एनवायरनमेंट के ऊपर अच्छा काम कर रहे हैं, अच्छी सोच है, उनको रिकॉग्नाइज किया जाए, जिससे दूसरों को इंस्पिरेशन मिले, इसलिए शुरू किया. ठीक है, ओके. टू,
हेलो सर, आई एम एक्चुअली फ्रॉम गॉड्स ओन कंट्री केरला, एंड इट्स बीइंग डिस्ट्रॉयड बाय अर्बनाइजेशन. So, is there anything that you can do to, like, get the government to focus on these problems?
Kerala is getting destroyed.
The problem really varies from urban sectors to urban sectors. Some states are doing a good job. As an example, Andhra Pradesh has started doing a good job. Telangana started doing a good job. Some states are doing a terrible job, like Karnataka, for instance. I think one can push it in policy forums. We are trying to do it at a operational level by working with those policy levels in terms of operationalizing actions towards sustainability, sensitivity. As a company, we are active, very active as we can be expected to be. And we have a track record of a fair amount of success, but we have restricted our involvement to a periphery which is in and around our campus, where we have a higher influence, not on a national basis or a state basis or a city basis. It is really the responsibility of the government and responsible citizens to choose their own territory of operation.
Thank you.
Three.
So what was the main goal of your life?
Sorry?
So main goal of his life.
The main goal of Mr. Premji's life. Good question.
To be successful in what I do and to do the best of what I can do.
Okay. Next round. Next round. I want to see three hands. Three hands. Three. Nobody at the back. Huh? Okay. I'm going to. So, you know, we have some time. Hamare paas kuch waqt hai. Isliye I'm going to keep coming back. I'm going to take three now and then again three later. So raise your hands so that I can see. Okay. The girl at the back. Number one. Number two. And you. Three. Okay. One, two, three.
Hello, sir. I would like to ask that what are the challenges faced by Wipro company in this competitive world to achieve sustainability?
What are the
challenges in this competitive world? Because the companies aim to get profit, and if they will invest their time and money to achieve sustainability, how they are coping with those challenges in this competitive world?
You know, I think too many issues on sustainability are deprioritized because of commercial interests. One has to be putting commercial interests secondary for sensitivity towards the environment. It does not always happen, but I think government policy should be directed towards it, and there should be proper enforcement of this policy on an ongoing basis. Just having policies which don't get enforced doesn't serve a purpose. And it requires pushback from people such as you, because you represent the population, and you all represent the emerging population with a sensitivity towards sustainability, and that's why you all are here.
I think the last point is absolutely critical, huh? Which is this, that if the general population, not just in this country, but across the world, really pushes back, makes it important, things will move. Yes? Okay. Great. Two.
Good morning, sir. So a company that combines a software company that is also concerned about sustainability is a new idea for many of us. And I was just wondering, as a company, how do you ensure that your employees are aware and are concerned about environmental issues? In your everyday functioning of the company, how do you ensure that employees are aware of these issues?
You know, we have communications which are on an ongoing basis. We have a sustainability council in which we have participation from senior management. We communicate the decisions of this sustainability council. And more important than anything else, we demonstrate it by action. That's the most highly carries the highest conviction, demonstrated by action, when you have a choice between a commercial interest and a sustainable interest, back the sustainable interest.
You know, there are many things. The communication that Mr. Premji talked about, the action that he's talking about is really the most crucial aspect. And the action is actually visible in pretty much everything that we do. So if you walked into this campus, you'll see how we have actually gone about, you know, water harvesting. Or if you look at the roof of this tower, the roof has solar photovoltaic integrated, right? If you go to our Electronic City campus, it's a truly remarkable place. The Electronic City campus is like a biodiversity park. And in fact, if you go there during the butterfly season, you know, you see some 50,000 butterflies. So I think this action that Mr. Premji is talking about, employees see it every day as they live and as they work. Yes.
Good morning, sir. Myself, Mohit from National Law University. My question is related to policy, the roadmap to policy formation. See, sir, we often see that there is a clash of interest between the commercial entities and the civilian rights. For example, there is a lobby in US, there's a lobby of lawmakers in US who absolutely deny the global warming, just so that they can get profits, so that they can earn more profits, more commercial profits. And we see often that the executive and legislative branch also fails miserably, and the judiciary has to intervene. This is the scenario in India. So, sir, my question is to you, that what is the roadmap that has to be observed by the lawmakers of this nation so that the clash of interests can be minimized?
That is the question. What you were saying is that there are very complex competing interests.
Clash of interest, right? Between commercial entities.
And therefore, what should lawmakers do? What kind of policy should be there so that environmental sustainability is pushed? That's the essence of what he's saying.
You know, I think just by having a plethora of laws will not serve the purpose. Government should focus on some key aspects which really damage sustainability and implement those intentions of the law. And that implementation thing is just very weak in government. Have a few things which have impact and see to it that they are implemented uniformly across the country.
So are we done with 1, 2, 3? Yeah? Okay, so agla 1, 2, 3 lenge. और आप लोग सवाल पूछें उससे पहले मैं ये आपको बता सकता हूं कि ये कतई जरूरी नहीं है, इट्स नॉट नेसेसरी एट ऑल दैट योर क्वेश्चंस आर लिमिटेड टू विप्रो अर्थियन और द मैटर ऑफ एनवायरमेंट, राइट? यू कैन आस्क एनी काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन दैट माय फ्रेंड आस्क्ड देयर. व्हाट डिड ही आस्क? व्हाट इज हिज गोल इन लाइफ, राइट? सो यू आर वेलकम टू आस्क एनी काइंड ऑफ अ क्वेश्चन. यू नो इट्स अ रेयर अपॉर्चुनिटी टू गेट होल्ड ऑफ हिम फॉर 1 hour and keep talking to him, right? So don't let it go. Yes? Okay, so I want to see hands. So I can't see hands. I mean, keep your hands up. Keep your hands up. Is she a student? I mean, I can't see from here. Okay, one there, then keep your hands up. Sorry? Yes, at this moment, only students can ask. We'll come to the teachers a little later. Okay, so number one. Number two. We'll come to you. Number two, okay? And, okay, number three there, behind the camera. There are two of you raising hands. I'll take the lady first and then the gentleman. Okay? So, clear? One, two, and three. Okay, go ahead.
Hello, sir. Myself, Ankita, from Xavier University, Bhubaneswar. My question to you is, what are the three books that has changed your life?
Three books that you've read
and it has changed your life or inspired you in any way?
You know, there's a very recent book by Satya Nadella, who has now been appointed as Chief Executive Officer of Microsoft. It's a very powerful book, and I would strongly suggest you read it. It's called Refresh. That's one book that gave me a completely different perspective vis-a-vis the priorities of an extremely successful business leader and his sensitivity to the environment, his sensitivity to relationships, and his sensitivity to bringing up his children. Both his children are handicapped children. And he takes a lot of his time and his wife's time to care for them, but he does, and he gives them very, very high priority. Let me just focus on one book.
You got one book.
Thank you so much, sir.
But you know, I must tell you this, that, I mean, he reads an incredible amount. So he's just constantly reading, and I think aap sab chhatron ke liye ye bahut zaruri baat hai ki aap log, you can imagine ki wo kitne busy hain, right? I mean, I don't think we can claim that we are as busy as him here, is it? Lekin I think that he ends up reading more than most of us. So he finds time, he reads. If I send something to him at night at 10 p.m., by next morning at 5 o'clock, he's read it, right? And most often when we have meetings, he has caught the mistakes on what I have written. What does it mean that I have not read it as carefully as he has read it, right? So reading is absolutely critical. Yeah? Okay. Were you two or were you, who was two? Number two? No. Okay. All right. Go ahead.
Good morning, sir. So my name is Trisha and I'm from City Montessori School. So my question to you is that, do you remember any of the mischievous activities with your friends in the school, and how did you develop your love for environment?
Do you remember any of your mischievous activities in school? Your mischief. And
you know, in the days when I was in school, teachers were permitted to give punishments, physical punishments. And I would have spent 60% of my time on my knees outside the class. That is a form of punishment. So you got used to it. You tried to wear trousers, so it didn't hurt too much.
Yeah, you heard him, right? That 60% of his time, 60% samay, kaksha ke bahar, घुटना टेके हुए उन्होंने बिताया है, ठीक है? लेकिन इसका मतलब ये नहीं है, this doesn't mean that if you spend 60% of your time outside the class, you'll become Mr. Premji. don't take that away from this, okay? Yeah, okay, good. Who was number three? Yeah, number three.
Good morning, sir. So we've all heard of.
Just put your hand up. Where are you?
I'm here, sir. Okay. So we've all heard of successful people's routines, and I just wanted to know if you have any such routines or practices that you attribute your success to.
All of us have routines and practices, habits.
Or even so principles.
Do you have habits? Sorry?
Routines and principles that...
Principles. So now they're two different things. Huh? Be careful.
Yeah,
you know. So what are your principles and what are your habits that have made you successful?
Well, as a person, I work very hard. You know, the world is very competitive and people are very bright and very effective. So the person who works harder generally tends to win out in terms of peer groups. I work very hard. Principle is, you know, I think we have built the organization on this, and that's a very fundamental principle. It's an uncompromising emphasis on integrity of character. And that's fundamental to build the muscles of an organization. It's fundamental to engender pride in employees. It's fundamental to do the right things all the time and not compromise on that fundamental one principle. We have other principles, but I think this takes the top of the list vis-a-vis the way the organization acts, the way the leadership in the organization acts, and our expectations from our team members in the organization.
You know, on the matter of habit, he said working hard. And on the matter of principle, he said integrity, right? And I can tell you that I have never worked for any other organization, right? So the only place I worked is this place. And I was in college when most of you were not born, right? So very long time ago. But I remember that the reason I joined Wipro, you know, even today, so many years now, 30 years perhaps, I joined Wipro not because Wipro was paying the best salary or, you know, some fancy stuff like that, but just for a very simple reason, and which was this, that Wipro at that point in time itself had the reputation of absolutely uncompromising integrity. If you were to work for this organization, you knew that you don't have to compromise. You can be completely honest. And that was a big thing, especially those days, right? So it's quite remarkable. And now I've worked here for so many years. And all these years, I can tell you, yes, not one second, not today. You know, today you can say that I have this important role here. But when I started off as a kid, not once were we left in doubt that do the right thing. Okay? Yeah. So next set of questions. Okay. So just be, you know, bahut sare haath hain mere ko. Aapko maine kaha tha, toh aap se pehle puchhunga. Will you, you'll ask. Number one, okay? And then, number two, Mr. Scout. Okay? And then, you are lobbying for somebody from there. Don't lobby, Avinash. Okay. No, you remember him. Huh? I'll come back to you because I can't see you clearly because of the camera. So just give me a minute. So one, two, and three. I will come, will come, will come. One, two, three. Okay, start.
Yes, sir.
Namaste. Bada jor se boliye.
Mera naam Mohammad Safiq hai. Purv Madhyamik Vidyalaya Tonda BKT Lucknow mein padhta hu. Mere wahan gaon mein
Buland awaaz.
Mere wahan gaon mein adhik saras aate the. Unke aane ke karan kya hai? Ab nahi aate hain wo.
Aapke gaon mein saras aate the. Ab nahi aate hain. Ha. Bataiye. तो ऐसा क्यों हो रहा है पूछ रहे हैं
yes,
कि उनको कैसे वापस बुलाया जाए ये पूछ रहे हैं
उनको कैसे वापस बुलाया जाए
अच्छा बहुत खूबसूरत सवाल है we used to get in his village there used to be a lot of migratory birds beautiful migratory birds they don't come anymore how can he call them back
give them some food it works give them some grains and put some water out, you know, in a elevated place so that they are able to see it. It works in most cases, but if the birds have migrated too far, it will not work.
You know, आपका जो सवाल है, उसमें बहुत सारी बातें छुपी हुई हैं, है ना? एक तो ये जो मिस्टर प्रेम जी कह रहे हैं कि क्या हम ख्याल रखते हैं, है ना, वही कह रहे हैं ना, क्या हम ख्याल रखते हैं, पहली बात तो ये है। दूसरी बात ये है कि क्लाइमेट चेंज के कारण पता नहीं क्या हो रहा है, माइग्रेशन पैटर्न्स कैसे बदल रहे हैं वो हमें मालूम नहीं है, ठीक है। बड़ा बहुत ही दिलचस्प सवाल है, मुझे तो लगता है कि मैं गुजारिश करूंगा अपने साथियों से जो अर्थियन को चलाते हैं, हैं, कि शायद अगले साल इसी थीम पे कुछ किया जाए कि हाउ डू वी गेट आवर माइग्रेटरी बर्ड्स बैक, है ना। इनके लिए तालियां बजाएं। थैंक यू सर।
मेरा नाम जगदीश है और मैं अदा भारत स्काउट एंड गाइड से भी जुड़ा हुआ हूँ और मैं राजस्थान से राजकीय उच्च माध्यमिक विद्यालय सुभाष नगर से आया हूँ। मैं आपसे पूछना चाहता हूँ कि ये विप्रो है क्या, मतलब ये क्या कंपनी है और ये इन्होंने जो कार्यक्रम चलाया है जो विप्रो अर्थियन अवार्ड्स, तो इस अवार्ड्स के जो पीछे जो कारण क्या था कि इसको मतलब ये हम प्रोजेक्ट मतलब दूसरे बच्चों को प्रोजेक्ट देंगे तो इससे पर्यावरण के प्रति ये जागरूक होंगे, तो मतलब ये बच्चे मतलब जागरूक तो होते हैं पर ये मतलब आपकी मतलब मेन क्या था मतलब।
तो विप्रो जो है वो कंपनी है और कंपनी जो है वो सॉफ्टवेयर में काम करती है, बहुत सारे काम करती है, सॉफ्टवेयर में काम करती है, आईटी में बड़ा बिजनेस है और साथ साथ में और भी बिजनेसेस हैं, लाइटिंग भी बनाती है, फर्नीचर भी बनाती है, साबुन बनाती है, तो बहुत बड़ा बिजनेस है दुनिया भर में, करीब 60 देशों से ज्यादा में काम है, करीब 170,000 मतलब करीब 1.7 लाख लोग काम करते हैं विप्रो के लिए। विप्रो शुरू हुई थी 1945 में, तो पिछले 25-30 सालों में बहुत बहुत सक्सेसफुल हो गई है और विप्रो ने अर्थियन शुरू इसीलिए किया है कि विप्रो को लगता है कि पर्यावरण की जो समस्या है वो इतनी महत्वपूर्ण समस्या है और उसका हल हो ही नहीं सकता जब तक सब लोग जुड़े ना। तो सवाल ये था कि सब लोगों को कैसे जोड़ा जाए पर्यावरण की समस्या से, इसलिए विप्रो ने विप्रो अर्थियन शुरू किया। जो मिस्टर प्रेम जी कह रहे थे कि विप्रो की डीएनए, उन्होंने कहा डीएनए में, डीएनए मतलब समझते हैं आप, मतलब अंदर ही है ना, डीएनए में पहले से ही है कि पर्यावरण के साथ हम किस तरह से मिलजुल कर रहे हैं। तो विप्रो एक कंपनी है और पर्यावरण के मामले में हमें लगता है कि बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण मुद्दा है, जब तक सब लोग मिलकर काम नहीं करेंगे तब तक ये काम नहीं हो सकता। तो हमें ये लगा कि अगर छात्र लोग इस पे जागरूक हो जाएं तो ना केवल आज काम होगा क्योंकि छात्र कल के नागरिक हैं, इसलिए फिर देश बदल जाएगा, दुनिया बदल जाएगी, है ना।
Good morning, sir. I'm Gayatri. I'm from Lekul Champaka. So we've understood that we've come a long way since where we started, like technologically wise. Nowadays, everyone is addicted to technology. So what can be done to integrate technological development with environmental development? Not just side by side, how can you use technology to, you know, do something for the environment?
Let me just go back to a little bit of history. When I was a child, TVs was not there. Television was not there. So the sources of entertainment were very few. So one spent a lot of time in sports, spent a lot of time playing, and spent a lot of time reading as a young person. I think that is something which the current generation is missing. They spend too much time sitting in the home, fixed either to their phones or fixed to the TV. It's very important that you look much beyond that, and you go out into the open, you play out in the rain, and you read. It's very fundamental. That's one. Technology can be used for sustainability in various ways. The most important, give you a simple example. For instance, LED lights versus the standard GLS bulb consumes significantly less energy than a GLS bulb for the same lumens or for the same light. That's one area where technology has really evolved, and LED lights has taken over really the source of light across the world, including in India. And a program launched by the government has been very successful of open bidding for it. A second area where now again, I think very rightly so, the government is focusing is on more sustainable generation of energy, solar, wind, versus the worst source of energy, which is coal-based. Hydro is in between the two. I think within the next 3 or 4 years, apart from, say, Germany, which is very advanced in this, we'll probably be having the highest source of sustainable energy as a percentage of the total energy we consume, which is something to be very proud of, because it has really caught like wildfire. And the pricing of that energy now is comparable with the pricing of conventional energy. Third area which I think also is going to be a technological development is electric cars. They will soon start eating very significantly into the share of diesel and petrol cars. Diesel and petrol cars generate a lot of emission and therefore pollute the atmosphere, whereas electric cars produce very little emission and therefore do not hurt the atmosphere. The key challenge today is the charging of the electric cars. You know, they're not in America now. Stations have come up, petrol stations have come up, where they give you a very concentrated dose of electric power to charge your car. The second is the cost aspects. The technology of electric cars makes it about 60% more expensive than a conventional car. But those prices are rapidly falling. And I can see a situation in 5 years where an electric car will be as competitive as a diesel or a petrol car. And we'll be able to go up to distances without a recharge of 300-400 kilometers, which is adequate for most requirements. Today, electric car has to be charged 60-70 kilometers, which makes it not convenient for traveling long distances. So technology is contributing towards trying to clean the environment more. And I think investments are going into that area.
Thank you. Who was number three? Nobody. I'm done with the next round. Okay. Acha, aisa bhi aisa karte hain. Ek round, one round for teachers. Is that okay? Acha, chalo bhai. Aap pooch lo, uske baad phir one round for teachers.
Namaste, sir. Hamara naam Ismail hai. पूर्व माध्यमिक विद्यालय टाउनजा से
बोलिए.
हमारे गांव में पहले घास के पौधे दवाई में काम आते थे, वो अब कम हो गए हैं. उनको कैसे ज्यादा फिर से कैसे आए?
आपके गांव में घास के पौधे थे और वो
दवाई कम, उनसे वो दवाई बनती थी,
उससे दवाई बनती थी, वो अब खत्म हो गया है
सर. बहुत कम हो गए हैं.
बहुत कम हो गए हैं. अच्छा अच्छा, कैसा घास था ये
सर? हर मेल की थी. बहुत मेल की. बहुत मेल की थी सर.
बहुत
अलग तरह की थी.
अलग तरह की थी. अच्छा अच्छा अच्छा, ठीक है. तो इन देयर विलेज देयर वाज सम काइंड ऑफ अ लेट्स से अ स्पीशीज ऑफ सर्टेन काइंड ऑफ अ ग्रास व्हिच दे यूज्ड टू मेक सर्टेन मेडिसिंस. किस तरह की दवाई थी?
बुखार की सर, हर चीज की थी, मतलब ज्यादा चीज की थी.
अच्छा.
और सर उसको खाने से दोबारा वो प्रॉब्लम आती नहीं थी.
अच्छा. तो वो दे यूज्ड टू मेक सम मेडिसिन आउट ऑफ इट. नाउ द ग्रास इज नो लॉन्गर ग्रोइंग, सो ही इज आस्किंग यू व्हाट कुड दे डू. बड़ा मुश्किल सवाल है, हैं? अब मुझे ये बताइए कि उनके पास कैसे जवाब हो सकता है इसका. है ना? हल बिल्कुल वाजिब है. हा? वाजिब समझ रहे हैं ना, है कि नहीं? सवाल बिल्कुल बढ़िया सवाल है, लेकिन उनके पास जवाब होना बड़ा मुश्किल है ना, है कि नहीं? फिर भी पूछते हैं.
पर ये क्यों हो गया आपके हिसाब से?
सर हम लोग क्या करें?
ऐसा हुआ क्यों? हुआ क्यों ऐसा? घास चली क्यों गई, ये पूछ रहे हैं वो.
सर हमको मालूम होता तो फिर हम पैसे.
Smart kid.
Smart kid. Smart.
You give an answer. I don't have an answer.
देखिए एक एक उन्होंने क्या कहा सुना आपने उन्होंने क्या कहा सुना उन्होंने कहा मेरे पास जवाब नहीं है ठीक है ना मेरे पास भी जवाब नहीं है ठीक है तो देखिए सवाल बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण है बहुत वाजिब सवाल है हम दोनों के पास जवाब नहीं है ठीक है हम लोग जवाब केवल इतना दे सकते हैं कि ये दुनिया भर में हो रहा है यही तो पर्यावरण की समस्या है और पर्यावरण की समस्या ऐसी समस्या नहीं है कि लोग कहते हैं कि भाई क्लाइमेट बदल रहा है तो 50 साल बाद कुछ होगा 100 साल बाद कुछ होगा वो सब दूर की बातें हैं उसको तो हम पर्यावरण की समस्या को तो हम आज झेल रहे हैं है ना तुम्हारे यहाँ घास खत्म हो गई उनके यहाँ वो सारस नहीं आते हैं है ना तो आज झेल रहे हैं इसीलिए जरूरी है कि इन समस्याओं से हम साथ मिलकर आज ही जूझें उसको परे ना करें ठीक है तो इसके आगे उस खास मुद्दे पर हम लोग को जवाब नहीं दे सकते फिर मेरे साथी वो कहां बहुत पर्यावरण के मामले में बड़ी बड़ी हस्तियां बैठी हुई हैं वहां पीछे वो दिनी बैठे हैं अभिजीत कहीं होंगे कहां है अभिजीत भाई है? नहीं है हाँ तो आप लोग उनसे मैं उनको कहूंगा आपसे बातचीत करने के लिए ठीक है लेकिन मैं आप लोगों से ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स हियर आई वांट टू टेल यू समथिंग अबाउट दिस क्वेश्चन ठीक है Asked, आपका नाम बताया इस्माइल ना
yes,
इस्माइल ने बहुत बढ़िया प्रश्न पूछा हम उनके पास जवाब नहीं है ठीक है तो उन्होंने क्या कहा व्हाट डिड ही से व्हेन इस्माइल आस्क्ड एक मिनट बेटा व्हेन इस्माइल आस्क्ड द क्वेश्चन व्हाट डिड ही सेड आई डोंट हैव एन आंसर राइट नाउ दैट्स अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इन लाइफ इवन इफ यू आर अजीम प्रेमजी You know, there are very many things you don't know, right? And when you don't know, you say honestly, you don't know, right? So that is a very critical thing in life. Huh? Despite being Azim Premji, having the honesty to say, I don't know, that's the only way you learn, right? Baat saaf hai na?
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, beta. Bahut badhiya prashn hai. To mere dost Abhijit wagaira se, dinhi kuch madad karo, bhai. ठीक है सवाल करो अभी नहीं बाद में ठीक है चाय के समय ठीक है बेटा इस्माइल वो दिनी वहां बैठे उनको पकड़ना कहाँ गए ओ यहाँ सर
सर हम जान नहीं पाए
वो बच्चे वो आपको जान जाएंगे ठीक है ओके वील गो टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन सो नाउ वन राउंड नो द स्टूडेंट्स जस्ट गिव मी अ मिनट वील डू अ राउंड विद टीचर्स इज इट ओके विद यू समथिंग विद द टीचर्स इज इट ऑलराइट Okay, teachers, raise your hand. And you have to prove to me that you are teachers. Right? Okay, just two hands. Okay, so we'll start with you. One, two, three. Okay, we'll start with you.
Good morning, sir.
A little louder, please. No, that's working. You just speak.
Good morning, sir. Myself, Kavita Shai from CMS. I feel that working on environmental projects, preparing the report is something else. And following the environmental practices, even a small practice, for example, not using the tissue paper every now and then we eat something instead using a handkerchief. Children work on these projects. We prepare reports. Many times we go out for some competitions, for these environmental competitions, where we see students from different branches, different schools, and other cities also. But what is missing is the students and the other people, they are not developing the attitude for saving environment. They work just for competition, they work for some contest, but that real attitude among every person is not only students, it's even the teachers also. The real attitude that should develop in a person, which will really help in saving environment, small steps, how to develop this attitude.
You know, I think leadership in these projects is very important. And the leadership should communicate to the students participating in the project what is the objective, what is the end output they expect, and what is the learning that they should expect from this project. So I think the responsibility really falls here on the teacher. who is generating these projects for the students. And if there's a lack of clarity in terms of what the project is, what it's hoping to achieve, and more important, what is the learning the students are supposed to get from it, I think it is a partly due to the failing of the teacher.
You know, this is again for the, you know, for everybody, but for teachers specifically, that it's important that we don't let anything become a ritual. Do you understand? Kisi bhi cheez ko, we should not make it mechanical. Ki project karna hai, project karke competition mein jana hai, competition mein jaake jeetna hai, phir yahan aake Mr. Premji ke yahan se award lena hai. That can't be the objective of anything. So, masla kya hai, uski jaan kya hai, uspe dhyan dena. That's what Mr. Premji is saying. Uspe dhyan dena, aur usme teacher ka bahut important role hota hai. Right? So, number two.
Morning, sir. At what age did you have inclination to towards environmental activities? And is it because of the upbringing in your family, or is it inborn in you?
One, certainly it is the influence of the family, of the parents, who set examples vis-a-vis the principles of sustainability. Also, one learned from one's teachers. You know, I happened to be in a school where the subjects were much beyond what was in the books. And teachers were well qualified. They were very sensitive to the environment. They were sensitive to building real citizens. And part of being a real citizen is also being sensitive to the environment. It's a combination of one's parents, one's teachers, and public figures who demonstrated examples of sustainability.
Thank you. Three.
Hello. Sir, मैं एक personal question पूछना चाहता हूँ. आपके company जब से start हुए, तब से आज तक, till now, आपका सबसे अच्छा दिन कौन सा है? और सबसे बैड दिन कौन सा?
बेस्ट डे, वर्स्ट डे. जब से कंपनी शुरू हुई?
जब से कंपनी स्टार्ट हुई टिल नाउ.
आई हैव टू थिंक. नॉट एन इजी क्वेश्चन. आई थिंक द वर्स्ट पीरियड वी वेंट थ्रू इज वी बिकेम indiscriminate in terms of our diversification. And that led to major failures and major losses. So if you ask me what I recollect as a semi-crisis we went through was indiscriminate, uncaring diversification. I think a major success, or what has really got us all motivated as an organization, was getting into the IT business and building a computer for virtually a white sheet of paper. And it became among the top three first developments of computers in the world. We put together an outstanding team. The team worked very, very hard. We gave the team all the leadership that we were capable of giving. And we produced something which was quite global in terms of its benchmarks. And that really got us into the IT business, because the product was a success. Bought like wildfire many years back, middle 80s.
Actually, that's a very, very fascinating story. What you're telling me, that 1985-86, mein kis tarah, 83-86, mein, जब आप सोचिए कोई इंडियन कंपनी है, वो डिसाइड करती है कि हम अपने यहां अपनी ताकत से, अपनी समझ से कंप्यूटर बनाएंगे. और हमने किया. और उसी आधार पे मेरे ख्याल से नींव डाली गई विप्रो के सक्सेस की. Okay, we'll go back to students. Okay, students, your hands. Students. Okay, the gentleman behind, are you a student? I can't see you. Ah, okay, fine. Now I can see you. So, number one, number two, this girl, yes? And number three. I'll come to you. Okay? Okay, go ahead, please.
Yeah. I'm Aditya from Sastra University, and my question is, if sustainability 4.0 comes into play like industrial 4.0, what will be its goal and motive, and what will be Wipro's role in it?
Sorry, just repeat the question.
If sustainability 4.0 comes into play like industry 4.0, the industrial revolution, what will be its goal and motive, and what will be Wipro's role in it?
Yeah, I mean, you know, okay, I get the question, but that's a question that I think I'll respond to. Sure. Do you want to take an opportunity to ask him a question?
No, it's okay. I just need an answer.
Come on.
You can reply. I don't understand it.
Come on. I'm giving you an option. This question you can ask me at tea. Sure. Okay, why don't you ask him a question?
No, that is the only question I have now. I'll maybe think of another question and ask him.
Come on. Something. Ask him.
No? Okay. The second time I've failed in being able to answer a question.
Ask him. Go ahead. Ask him something general. Come
okay,
on.
Like your transition from being a student to a professional, how did you take it up in your life?
Moving from a student to being a professional.
Yeah.
You know, I think one should never stop being a student. The advantage of being a student is you're always learning. And the change is happening so rapidly today for a professional that unless he's always learning, he's getting himself obsoleted. So you have to cultivate the habit of learning to learn. You know, we have so many people who are so successful in our organization who have been 20 years with us and given virtually their life for the company, but they've forgotten to learn to learn. And then they become blocks is because people under them also are not able to grow because their bosses are not able to grow. It's a very fundamental property. A very fundamental mindset that you have to always keep learning, irrespective of the job you're doing.
Great. So that is a great question and it's a great answer.
Thank you
so much. Yes. And I'll respond to you at tea, okay? Yeah. Hey, you speak loudly. It's okay. Don't worry. The mic is working.
My name is Rukia.
Closer and louder.
Hello. Yeah. Okay. Good morning. My name is Rukia and I'm from Holy Angels. The question that I wanted to ask is, as a child, sir, who was your role model?
Very nice.
You know, I've had many, many role models. And, you know, I cannot identify one person who was my role model. One learned a lot from people for diverse things. And, you know, I would say maybe I had 20 role models in terms of people one learned from. I didn't have any one role model.
Can you name some of them?
Sorry?
Could you name some of them? One or two of them?
One very obviously is Mahatma Gandhi, is because he was a role model. The other person was Jack Welch of General Electric, who was the chairman and CEO of General Electric for many, many years. The third was my mother. She was a role model.
That was three.
Good morning, sir. I am Shruti Yadav from City Montessori School, Lucknow. So my question to you is, as a human being, what do you think is important for someone to truly be a human?
Care for people. Very simple.
Thank you.
I hope everybody got that. Sabko samajh mein aaya? Hai na? Bahut mahatvapurna baat thi. Care for people. Yes? Okay. So that's... Well, are we done with the next round? 1, 2, 3? Okay. Next round of hands, please. Next round of hands. Haath khade rakhiye. Isko bichare ko maine bahut der se ignore kiya hai, to main isse shuru karunga. Ek. Theek hai? Number one. उसके बाद हाथ खड़े रखिएगा नंबर टू. हाँ ठीक है नंबर टू. फिर भाई तुमने तो एक बार सवाल पूछ लिया है ना. नहीं पूछा है. अच्छा चलो नंबर थ्री. ठीक है ओके विल स्टार्ट हियर.
गुड मॉर्निंग सर. माई सेल्फ राहुल कुमार गेंद्रे फ्रॉम छत्तीसगढ़ एट गवर्नमेंट हायर सेकेंडरी स्कूल घुघवा करसा दुर्ग. मेरा आपसे आज का क्वेश्चन है कि हम अभी विप्रो अर्थियान के अंतर्गत बायोडाइवर्सिटी में प्रोजेक्ट के रूप में क्रिएटिविटी एक्टिविटी किए हैं. ठीक है तो इसके अलावा अपन स्कूल में हमारे स्कूल में पर्यावरण के क्षेत्र में और कौन कौन से एक्टिविटी कर सकते हैं.
As a part of the Wipro earthian program, they've done an activity on biodiversity. What other activities can they do in their own school, in their homes, around the environment? Actually, बहुत कुछ कर सकते हैं आप लोग. पानी के मुद्दे पे कर सकते हैं. पानी का मुद्दा.
पिछले बार हमारे स्कूल वाटर एंड सस्टेनेबिलिटी के ऊपर भी प्रोजेक्ट में काम किए थे तो हमारा स्कूल 11th रैंक पे आया था उस टाइम.
तो देखिए मेरी सलाह आप लोगों सबसे ये है कि सबसे महत्वपूर्ण बात यह है कि आप उसको प्रोजेक्ट के रूप में ही ना देखें. आपने प्रोजेक्ट किया ना बायोडाइवर्सिटी पे किया पानी पे किया कभी.
जी सर.
अब कोशिश ये करनी चाहिए कि इस सब चीज का इस्तेमाल कैसे हो आपके शहर या गांव में. क्या आप कम्युनिटी के साथ कुछ कर सकते हैं. जैसे आपके आसपास कहाँ है आपका स्कूल.
छत्तीसगढ़.
किस जगह.
दुर्ग जिला पाटन.
पाटन.
जी सर.
पाटन में कुछ किया जा सकता है क्या. तो अपनी बात को आप केवल स्कूल तक सीमित मत रखिए.
हाँ सर.
ठीक है ना. बाहर ले जाने की कोशिश करिए चाहे वो आसपास के घरों में हो आसपास के मोहल्लों में हो. तालाब है ना आपके यहाँ.
जी सर.
हैं छत्तीसगढ़ में तो तालाब ही तालाब है. ठीक है तो तालाब में की अब कर कुछ करिए. ठीक है तो एक्सटेंड करिए आप लोग. ठीक है ना.
मेरा सेकंड क्वेश्चन भी है सर.
नहीं अब वापस करेंगे.
थैंक यू सर.
अभी बैठ जाएंगे. ओके कौन हुआ नंबर टू. तो अगर वक्त बचेगा तो वापस आएंगे आपके पास. है
हेलो आई एम करण सलगावकर एंड माय क्वेश्चन टू यू इज व्हाट आर द फ्यूचर एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ विप्रो अर्थियान एंड हाउ आर वी गोइंग टू इनकॉर्पोरेट विद दिस प्रोजेक्ट एट अ हाई लेवल.
जस्ट रिपीट द क्वेश्चन अगेन. आई मीन
व्हाट आर द फ्यूचर एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ विप्रो अर्थियान एंड हाउ आर वी गोइंग टू इनकॉर्पोरेट विद दिस प्रोजेक्ट एट अ हाई लेवल.
See, the Wipro earthian program, sit down. The Wipro earthian program will continue to expand meaning more schools, more colleges, right? So that's one important thing. I hope that is clear because we reached out to 55,000 schools and colleges. Hopefully next year it will be 75,000. Then year after that it will be 100,000. So we will reach out to many more colleges. So that is one kind of a thing that will happen. The second kind of a thing that will happen is that you've done biodiversity projects. Earlier there was water project. He asked this wonderful question about the migratory birds. So we will do various kinds of things, right? So expand, do various kinds of things. And most importantly, I think at some point in time, we will really be excited if schools and colleges are able to do something about what I just responded to him. Meaning taking it out. Can you make your school not just do a project, but can you make your school the most environmentally sustainable school in your area? How will you do that? You know, can you have perfect water neutrality? Meaning how much ever water is there, you're reusing it, using it well. Can you do something about biodiversity in your school, right? So that is what we would like to really see. Okay, good question. Yes.
But the most important thing is build it into your life. Just don't build it into a project because the project starts and the project ends. Whereas it should be part of your personality. It should be part of your ongoing habits in terms of sensitivity towards the environment.
Who was number three? Yeah.
Sir, mera naam Ujwala Popat Mane. मैं आपसे एक क्वेश्चन पूछना चाहती हूँ. पर्यावरण सुधारने के लिए आपने जो कोशिश की है उस पर आप खुश है क्या. आखिर आप क्या चाहते हैं.
What you've done with the environment, you're happy. Lekin, what do you want? What is it that you want ultimately?
No, I'm not happy with how much we have done for the environment. So much more we can do, so much more we can scale, so many more areas we can be exploring. So I'm not happy with what we have done. And I give this feedback to him also.
वो क्या कह रहे हैं समझे? वो ये कह रहे हैं कि वो खुश नहीं हैं, बहुत ज़्यादा अभी बहुत कुछ करना है और वो मेरी बुराई कर रहे हैं. वो कह रहे हैं कि तुम ठीक काम नहीं कर रहे हो. ठीक है, अभी बहुत कुछ करना बाकी है, ये कह रहे हैं. लेकिन आपके सवाल में एक दूसरा भी सवाल था ना कि आप चाहते क्या हैं, है ना? What do you want? It's a very deep question.
Very deep question.
आपने इतना
I'm very fond of the outdoors, and I would want that whenever one steps out of the house, one is not polluted with the environment. It cannot be as pure as what you find in the mountains, but it should be tolerably pure, and then one can get encouraged to go more and more out of the house.
चाहते ये हैं कि उनको ये बहुत पसंद है कि वो बाहर रहें. बाहर मतलब कमरों के अंदर, घरों के अंदर ना रहें, बल्कि बाहर पर्यावरण से जुड़ के रहें. जैसे उनके साथ अगर मान लीजिए कोई मेरी मीटिंग होती है ना, तो कई बार हमारी मीटिंग ना कमरे के अंदर नहीं होती है. हम लोग दोनों वॉक करने चले जाते हैं, तो एक घंटा डेढ़ घंटा वॉक कर रहे हैं. तो उनको ये बहुत पसंद है. तो बहुत सिंपली वो ये कह रहे हैं कि वो चाहते ये हैं कि जब भी कोई बाहर जाए तो उसको ऐसा ना लगे कि उसके ऊपर प्रदूषण का या और किसी समस्या का जोर चल रहा है. सबको ये लगे कि बाहर जाके आराम से रह सके. तो क्या ऐसी दुनिया नहीं हो सकती? वो ये कह रहे हैं. ठीक है ना? ओके. मुझे ना अभी यहां पर लिख के ये मिला है कि आखिरी तीन प्रश्न पूछे जाएं, क्योंकि उसके बाद फिर फोटो वोटो कुछ लेना है आप लोगों के साथ, है ना? राइट. सो आखिरी तीन प्रश्न. आप लोगों को मालूम है टेलीविजन में एक रैपिड फायर राउंड होता है, हैं? रैपिड फायर करना है. रैपिड फायर करेंगे तो 10 क्वेश्चन ले सकते हैं. करेंगे क्या? शैल वी डू अ रैपिड फायर? बट द क्वेश्चन इज वेदर ही विल बी एबल टू रिस्पॉन्ड इन रैपिड फायर, नॉट वेदर यू कैन आस्क. शैल वी ट्राई? ओके, वी विल डू अ रैपिड फायर. इफ इट डजंट वर्क देन वी विल स्टॉप. ओके, rapid fire means you have to ask a short question and he will say, give a short response. Is it okay? Okay, question one. I'm not going to do one, two, three. So question one, with you, man. Quick. Rapid fire means, you know, it has to be rapid fire.
Do you believe in mindfulness, the concept being mindful?
Do you believe in mindfulness?
What do you mean by mindfulness?
Being so it's a new age practice we keep on hearing. Be mindful, be more aware, you know, of your thoughts become action.
I'm gonna cut that, you know, because it's not rapid fire anymore.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay, question two. Hugh.
Sir, can you name one thing in your bucket list?
One thing in
your bucket list.
Whose bucket list are you talking about? Mine? His.
One thing in your bucket list.
One thing in your bucket list meaning there's one thing that you want to do, want to make sure that happens, you know, before you sort of...
I wish I could be as young as you are.
Thank you.
Okay. Number three. Come on. Rapid fire. We're going to do rapid fire. Okay, next you. Yes. I'm going to come.
What is your dream for Earthian?
We want to scale it. We want to scale it much more. And but more important than that, we want you people to be ambassadors for it.
So be ambassadors.
What you learn from this, be a strong ambassador for it. Because then we are really scaling in terms of its penetration across the country.
Thank you.
All right, number four. Okay, we'll go there. Go at the back. Yeah, come on. Yeah, go ahead. Quick.
Sir, do you think there should be a very big revamp in the education system?
Should there be a very big revamp in the education system?
Oh, without question. Very, very big.
Very big revamp. You know, I'm not sure whether you know, this is not a rapid fire, just a minute. Huh? I'm not sure whether you know this, that what Mr. Premji has done is that Mr. Premji has actually gifted away most of his wealth. Yeah, not the giving pledge. He has gifted away the most of his wealth. He's actually given it. So it's not a pledge. Pledge means I will give. He has actually given it away, right? So most of his wealth, he has given it away to the foundation. And the foundation actually works on the matter of trying to help improve education. And we also do some very other important things like helping not-for-profit organizations that work with women at risk of violence, anti-trafficking on the matter of nutrition. So he not only believes in it, he's not just responding to you, he's actually done more than pretty much anybody has done in the past 100 years in this country. Okay. उनको ये पूरा विश्वास है कि देश की शिक्षा को आमूलचूल परिवर्तन की जरूरत है और उसके लिए उन्होंने अपनी अधिकांशतः संपत्ति जो है वो एक फाउंडेशन को दे दी है जो फाउंडेशन स्कूलों के साथ काम करती है और भी कुछ कुछ इस तरह के काम करती है ठीक है ओके आर यू आस्किंग मी टू कट शॉर्ट नाउ और आई कैन कीप गोइंग ओके ग्रेट फाइन Hands up, please. Okay, we'll hear. Yes.
Sir, can you name any ideal teacher you had?
Any ideal teacher, your ideal teacher that you had?
When you were a student.
It was Mr. Dyer who used to teach us English. But he taught us much more than English.
Okay, next. Go there.
How can we become like you?
Okay.
How can we become like you?
As a start working harder than you're working.
Did you get that? तो उन्होंने सवाल पूछा कि वो हम लोग कैसे आप जैसे बन सकते हैं? उनका जवाब ये है कि सबसे पहले ज़्यादा मेहनत करो. ठीक है मेहनत करने से बहुत कुछ होता है ओके नेक्स्ट गो टू यू ओके नाउ वी गोना डू रियली लास्ट थ्री आफ्टर दिस हां यस
नमस्ते सर मेरा नाम आदित्य सिंह है मैं पूर्व माध्यमिक विद्यालय में पढ़ता हूं लखनऊ मैं आपसे एक प्रश्न पूछना चाहता हूं हम अपने गांव में हिंदी ही पढ़ते हैं हिंदी ही बोलते हैं बिना इंग्लिश के हम क्या आपकी तरह आगे बढ़ सकते हैं
Can you advance by just speaking Hindi? I mean,
we speak Hindi, we speak only Hindi, but can we actually go ahead in life and become like you without speaking English?
Well, our Prime Minister only speaks in Hindi nowadays. He is the most senior member in our cabinet. So there is no handicap in terms of what language you speak.
बहुत important बात कह रहे हैं, हाँ? उन्होंने क्या कहा उन्होंने कहा कि हमारे प्रधानमंत्री जो हैं वो हिंदी में ही बोलते हैं है ना तो ऐसा मत समझिए कि अगर आप अंग्रेजी नहीं बोलते हैं तो उससे आपको कोई नुकसान होगा जिंदगी में आगे बढ़ सकते हैं मेहनत करने से कोई जरूरी नहीं है कि अंग्रेजी आए ठीक है कभी अपने दिल में यह मत रखिएगा कि आप अंग्रेजी नहीं पढ़े हिंदी माध्यम में पढ़े या मराठी में पढ़े तो उससे कोई नुकसान होगा ऐसा नहीं होता है ठीक है ना
धन्यवाद
आत्मविश्वास रखिएगा ठीक है ओके Okay, I'm going to do a reverse count now. Three, yeah, that's three. Then I'm going to go to two and one. Three, yeah, boliye.
Sir, aap bachpan mein shararati the aur agar.
Jose.
Aap bachpan mein shararati the aur agar the, to kis tarah ki shararate karte the?
Dekhiye, shararati to the, वो तो उन्होंने बता दिया है क्योंकि बाहर बैठे रहते थे उनको घुटने पे क्या शरारत करते थे ये पूछ सकते हैं सिंस यू आर वेरी नॉटी व्हेन यू आर अ किड गिव एन एग्जांपल ऑफ योर नॉटीनेस
नॉट पेइंग अटेंशन इन क्लास
मतलब बाहर देखते रहते थे लोगों को कुछ कुछ फेंकते रहते थे ऐसा कुछ करते थे ओके थ्री वी गो टू टू नंबर टू नंबर टू नंबर टू नंबर टू नंबर टू या
What's the one thing that you do every day to keep yourself happy?
I look at the greenery around my house.
He looks at the greenery around his house. And very green his house is. Thank you. Okay, the last question for Wipro Earthian Award 2017. The last question. I have this power to give it to one person. Which one person, right? So I'm going to give it to the youngest person that I can see. Ekdam koi. You are not the youngest person. Okay, raise your hands, please. Raise your hands.
जो सबसे छोटे हैं उनसे वो उनका जो सवाल है उनसे पूछना चाहते हैं अनुराग जी कोई पूछना चाहता है जो आखिरी सवाल है आज का एकदम आखिरी सवाल okay. जो भी झट से
The girl in the green jacket.
So with all this pollution
speak going, louder please.
So with all this pollution going on, can we do anything as citizens? Can we do anything to stop people polluting the city?
So with all this pollution going on, Can we do something as citizens to stop people from polluting the city?
Yeah.
That is your question.
Yeah.
Okay. Good question to end this program on.
What's your name?
Huh? Vani.
You know, as a start devoting part of your time to issues which reduce pollution. Because as a young person doing that, you can set a very, very strong example. You do what you have to do to reduce pollution. That answer is simple. The question is that you should do it consistently.
You know what he's saying? He's saying that if somebody like you was to spend some time on trying to reduce pollution, it will be a wonderful example to others. Huh? That's what he's saying. Okay? So you can start doing it. Yes? Will you? Okay, good. Thank you so much. So, thank you. With that last question, we end this session. Mr. Premji, thank you so much. Okay.